Access granted.
Hello there, amazing people of YouTube. Today we are going to I will going to show you guys how to install the latest kernel in OpenSUSE Leap. I don't know why I said it that way, but basically we are going to take like the the latest kernel from their build service and then install it into OpenSUSE Leap. I don't recommend you guys doing this if you have like a production environment or you really really want stability and all that, because it's not been like tested that much. Like, it don't have like basically this quality control yet that you would say the kernel that you're using right now. And I would also only say to do this if you have hardware problems, that you can't get some hardware to work or stuff like that, then this could be a solution for you. But anyway, I will show you guys how to. So as you guys can see right now, I'm on 4.0.0-4 blah blah, so numbers vanilla. So it's basically the 5.0 kernel vanilla. They haven't I think they still have a little bit of OpenSUSE tweaking in the kernel, but I'm not totally sure how that is. We can look at that a little bit later. But basically how you get this is, I will put this link to the that you need to use in the description. But if you go into like downloads.opensuse.org, this is basically the download server for their distribution, Tumbleweed, factory and build service. And what we are going to utilize is their build service. So this is like what you come up to on the landing page or first page. So you see here you have debug, distribution, factory, history, ports, repository source, Tumbleweed, update. So basically distribution. This is in here like the stable and current version and leap and whatnot of the distribution. So this is basically what comes with your get in here, like you get live ISOs and all that, right? And go up to leap here, 5.1 ISOs. So you see you get build blah blah blah, you get ISOs here. And the same if you go down to like Tumbleweed, you can get ISOs here also. So you get the idea. Where are they in these folders up here? There should be an ISO in here somewhere. Oh, here they are. Yoink. But let's go back. So what we want to do, we want to go into repositories. So think of this like basically like PPAs in Ubuntu. This is kind of like the same idea that we're doing. We're taking a user contributor or an outside the repository, adding it to the package manager and then installing it from there. So you have all kind of categories here, so you can basically just go in and look here. I would say for the most part it's a much easier and a much more useful to just go into the build service. So here you can choose what distribution you want to search for and what package. So we can take like Tumbleweed, OBS, and if that's in the repository someone have provided, it will come up here, but you guys get the idea. Oh, here you can see kernel OBS blah 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 blah, and then you will like view one, and then you will basically just download the RPM file for that one, direct install here, and you can do that with Leap and also. So it's basically the back end to all this that we are looking at in here in repository. So let's go back to repositories. We want to go down to kernels. Kernel? I think we say all the different kernels, all the way to like OpenSUSE 12.1, Linux Next, the SLE versions, the Stable X or Xen or what it's called, Stable. There's another Stable, I think that's the sources, tools, vanilla. And we just want to go into the Stable. And we want to have the standard, so that's basically A586, I686, no arts, source, repo data, source files, x86, 64. So that's the one that we were going in. We've seen here, we have like basically the latest kernel. Is mine up to date? I don't think it is. So we can see how to update it. But anyway, this is like where we want to extract the kernel from. So basically what you do is, it's actually really, really easy. You go into your YAS tool, You go into software repositories. Wait for it to start up. Boom, 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 boom. You add a repository by clicking add, and you're going into HTTPS. Click next. Give it a name. Cur. And then you basically take this link up here, copying it, putting it in here. And I already have it in here, but then you click next, and it will ask you, this is from, this have like an untrusted key, do I want to use it? You just click yes and tick the box that says, don't ask me about this again. And then we'll basically just add this repository to your repository list and refresh it. So we want to abort because I already have it in there. If you go up here and look at my repositories. Yoink. Oh, I did call it cur. So this is the one that I added. So we go into edit it. So you see here. This is the link that I'm using. Okay. And then of course click OK and it will refresh it and everything. All changes will be lost. Yeah, whatever. I didn't change anything. Then we go into your software manager. You can also do it from the command line, and maybe that would be easier. Or this is, I don't know. Some people just like command. I still think for in this specific case, this is way easier to figure out because it's just a little bit more intuitive instead of using a long command. But it's faster from the command line. But anyway. You go up to view, and you have to have packet groups clicked. You see that's the one here. I don't think that comes by default. Then you go down to multiversions. And then you can see here you have your kernels. So you have the default standard kernel 4.12. That's the one that comes with Leap right now. Then you have the vanilla here. So the standard kernel without any SUSE patches. And then you have the PEE version here, so this can support blah 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 blah. So you basically have like different versions of the vanilla here, the dev versions, and this is Samus mod version. I will just go with the standard one. That's what I'm using right now. And then you basically just tick these. So let's say if this was vanilla, you basically just click it for install, and you click accept. And it will find all the dependencies and all that, and it will install it for you. And then of course you have to reboot the system, and after you rebooted the system, it will automatically boot into the latest kernel. But again, only do this if you want to tinker a little bit with the system, if you want an updated kernel, or if you have hardware problems that you need a newer kernel. Other than that, go to Tumbleweed or something like that. But just for the fun of it, I could just like doing this because I really like the stability of like the software in Leap. The only thing that I sometimes miss is are like some really few more up-to-date areas of the operating system, like the kernel and some other stuff. So I hope this helped out. If you have any questions about my really weird way of explaining this, then ask down below and I will guide you through it, so you can get get it set up easier in a way that you understand it. But like I said, I will have this link down below in the description. So again, you just take this one, go into repositories, just to make sure, add one, HTTPS, next, name, post in there, next, and all that. Go into the software manager, go into enable packet groups, click on the packet groups tab, go into multiversion package, and then basically select the kernel that you want. This one should suffice, should be way enough. I just like the vanilla kernel for some weird reason, but anyway, you get the idea. Thanks for watching, and like I said, if you have any questions, ask down below, and I'll see you all later. Bye bye.